In a recent study, the University of Pennsylvania tested healthcare providers' implicit and explicit attitudes towards lesbian women and gay men. They prove that health providers such as EMTs, nurses, and doctors showed a dramatic preference for lesbian women over gay men. Is this the case at Texas Lutheran University? Or on a larger scale, is this the case of our surrounding community? We set out to interview current members of the gay community in TLU to get their input from their firsthand experience.
Society's view on the gay specifically, I'm not addressing lesbian, I feel like has always been flamboyant.
They're a risk, they're predatory.
Flamboyant, and then there's also a lot of people just think promiscuous.
People don't really realize that most gay men are just people. They assume they're feminine males.
I know quite a few people, a lot of guys, who they're okay, they don't care if you're gay, but if you're a feminine gay, they want nothing to do with you. They're definitely a lot more sexualized, but when it comes to acceptance-wise, I think that they're also more accepted, but it's kind of at a cost.
You're at a club and you're a couple of women making out. It's hot if you're at a club and you're two dudes making out. It's disgusting.
Because they're not really accepted as lesbians or as gay people, they're accepted as sex objects, really.
That's just kind of an effect of women being objectified in general. Put two women together, two objects, that's just a further fetishization. I don't think lesbian relationships get taken very seriously.
The opposite, in my opinion. I feel that people view lesbians as more butch, male-dominant females.
Across all margins, we saw a reoccurring theme. Lesbians are sexualized and gay men are considered disgusting. In order to prove that this polarization exists, we chose to test this by placing one gay and lesbian couple outside of Walmart to get real-time reactions from the shoppers.
That is so crazy. Yeah. What else did y'all see? How do you feel right now?
Well, I don't know. I thought we were going to get many looks because we thought that people wouldn't care.
We saw other couples right there. No one gave a crap about them. You know what I mean? But then when they saw us, oh shit, like y'all hell broke loose.
Okay, there was a guy with a blue hat. He caught, like, passed by us and called us a faggot.
Yeah.
It was fucking crazy. I was like, well, then I was going to go confront him. But then
as soon as he said it, he started like returning around and then he started walking faster.
It wasn't even embarrassing. Like, imagine if I was actually gay. I think I'd be pretty frustrated. I don't know how they would deal with this. I'd be confronting everyone. Like, I'm gonna fucking, like, what are you looking at? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Right. We're good.
It's okay.
Right, thank you.
We just sat on a bench together. I laid my head on his lap, you know, something that I've seen a lot, I guess, you know, right? People passed by, they did look at us, but nothing hostile, I guess. The one thing that did make us feel uncomfortable was this guy came up to us and he asked us if we were lovers. And we're like, yeah, he just walks in. And like,
yeah, I mean, I did feel really uncomfortable because I saw him while he was walking towards us in the parking lot, mm-hmm. and then he was like staring the whole time, and then he asked us that, and then it made me feel uncomfortable when he asked that.
I don't know, I was a little nervous about it, but other than that, people aren't that bad.
Yeah.
Went to the gas station by McDonald's. It was very, very uncomfortable.
Every single man in there stared at us. Like, consistently throughout the entire time we were in there. Some of them weren't making it too, like, secret either.
Yeah, like, they were blatantly looking at our asses.
And I've never stared at it like that. That was very, it was almost hostile. Like, yeah. I felt, like, in danger, kind of.
Yeah, like predator-prey type of thing. It was really, really, really uncomfortable. It's not the same experience that y'all went through.
I mean, it's probably a little worse considering that everyone wants to, like, see you guys.
Yeah, I swear every single guy
in some sexual way, yeah.
Like, and it was blatantly staring. Okay, so we went to Walmart and we sat outside on a bench and held hands and whatever, and people really didn't pay attention to us. Like, they would look and stuff, but it felt more normal. People accepted it more, I think. Especially more than the gay experiment we did. People seemed to not care as much that two girls were sitting together than two guys sitting together.
It wasn't that bad. I mean, I felt like people just accepted it, But I think the only attention that we did get was from, like, the older men.
Yeah.
But that was it. It was okay.
It wasn't that bad.
I refused to dance with a man in Green, Texas, and so he ran his truck at me and my potential partner.
Being in a small town, it's generally a lot more conservative, and especially when you grow up going to church and all you hear in those kind of churches is that you're going to hell. And a lot of the people in those towns generally feel the same way.
I lost a lot of extended family, friends. Since then, though, I mean, I don't consider that harassment in the sense that you are probably thinking of. Other than that, it's just, you know, a general sense you get off people, but generally people who you already disliked anyway for unrelated reasons.
Well, I mean, I definitely went through a long time where I hated myself just because I was gay. But then it's like once you come out, it's really like a totally different story.